solution is very simple. We have to forget, when we speak about facial melanoma, we have to forget about the melanoma-specific criteria. We have to look for the benign features. Okay, so the method is very simple. If I look at the lesion on the face, I ask myself, do I see clear-cut, prevalent, predominant benign features? Yes. Okay, so that's a benign lesion. I'm relaxed. But if I don't see any of the six benign features listed here, or I don't see that they are prevalent, predominant in the lesion I'm looking at the moment, then I have to stop and think. I have to avoid making a cryo, avoid making a laser, taking a picture and asking the patient to come back, you know, in a few months, or taking a biopsy. But I have to stop and think. Okay, so let's review for a moment the method. First of all, let's understand what are the six benign features. This is the list. Number one is scales, okay? Scales are what? Are, of course, one of the features of pigmented and non-pigmented actinic keratosis. In fact, scales can be pigmented or non-pigmented. Then, number two, white follicles and or rosettes. So white follicles and rosettes are, typically seen in AKs, pigmented AKs, yeah? White follicles when we use non-polarized light dermatoscopes, and rosettes when we use polarized light dermatoscopes. Okay, then number three, again in PAK or non-pigmented AKs, erythema or reticular vessels. Okay, so the first three are the criteria we find in one of the two main differential diagnoses of facial melanoma, so pigmented or non-pigmented actinic keratosis. The last three criteria are seen in the second main differential diagnosis we have on the face, which is benign lentigo, solar lentigo, okay? And this is what? This is reticular lines or fingerprints. These are very, very often the same, sharp demarcation of the pigmentation of the periphery, and the presence of classic seborrheic keratosis criteria like milia-like cysts, comedo-like openings, and so on. Okay, let me give you an example. This is a very ugly-looking lesion clinically, but as you can see demoscopically, I see clear-cut, prevalent benign features. What are they? They are, first, these are pigmented scales, okay? These are brownish, very superficially located brownish lines, circumscribing a little bit the follicles. And here you can see that they're very superficial. You will see that it's very easy to recognize that these are just pigmented scales, okay? So pigmented scales are basically never seen in facial melanoma. Okay, so many pigmented scales and also many white follicles. You see, these are follicles which are white in color, some of them showing rosettes. What is a rosette? The rosette is a combination of four white dots within the follicle. This is due to a physical, optical phenomenon due to the polarization of our dermatoscope, okay? So four dots in the follicle are called rosettes, okay? So pigmented scales, white follicles, rosettes, these are plenty of benign features. I can be on the safe side diagnosing this lesion as a pigmented AK. This is another PAK, and as you can see here, we can see again a number of rosettes. Here we have a very, very nice one, a second one, a third one, a fourth one here, and many others at the bottom of the lesion. Then we have what? We have non-pigmented scales. Huh? And then we have what? We have background erythema. Okay. So what do you like to see more? These are all the three criteria we usually see in combination in pigmented actinic keratosis. Okay, this is the same lesion pictured on the left with a non-polarized light dermatoscope and on the right with a polarized light dermatoscope. And here you see the difference. In the circle, you see that we have plenty of white follicles here, while on the right, instead of the white follicles, we see rosettes, okay? And if I ask you, what are these pigmented, brownish pigmented lines? These are nothing than pigmented scales, okay? So we have pigmented scales, we have white follicles, and we have the third criterion, background erythema. So again, clear-cut PAK. This is a classic strawberry pattern we find in non-pigmented AK with these white follicles and a reticular vessels, so kind of red network. Okay. Here again, a very ugly looking lesion clinically, as you can see here on the left, but look dermoscopically. Dermoscopically, if I ask myself, do I see benign features? Yes, I do. I see many fingerprint-like structures, reticulation or fingerprint-like structures, so parallel lines, as you can see here, parallel lines, and also sharp demarcation of the lesion on the periphery. So this is clear-cut benign lentigo, okay? And even if I see a little bit of gray color, who cares, okay? The predominant features are pointing out to a solar lentigo, okay? On the left side again, do I see benign features? Yes, I see network, I see reticulation. And this reticulation is typical of solar lentigo. Okay, so here we are again on the safe side. This is a benign lentigo. Look at the lesion on the right. Do I see benign features? Yes, I see clear cut, sharp demarcation of the lesion at the periphery. Sharp demarcation, you see? And therefore, again, this is really diagnostic for a benign lentigo. Okay, here again, do I see benign features? Yes, I see them. An area typified by milia-like cysts and comedo-like openings in the circle, and then parallel lines, so kind of fingerprint-like structures, again, at the periphery of this lesion. And even if there is a little bit of gray color, again, in this lesion, then who cares, okay? Now, you can see from this lesion, if we invert, we do... this inverse, we apply this inverted approach, this inverse approach, then we come to the right conclusion. If we start looking for gray color, we see gray color and we say, oh my God, this could be a melanoma. But if we say, ask ourselves, do I see prevalent benign features? My answer is yes, I see them. And therefore, I don't care about the tiny gray color, spots of gray color I can see in this lesion. Okay, so again, how the method is working. Left side, do I see benign features? Yes, I do. I see predominant reticulation. Therefore, this is a benign feature. This is a benign lesion. This is solar lentigo. On the right side, do I see clear-cut benign features? Well, no. I'm sorry, I don't. Why? Because the periphery of the lesion is not sharply demarcated. I don't see white follicles. I don't see scales. I don't see erythema. I see maybe just a little bit of reticulation here, but it's not enough. It's not prevalent within the lesion. By the way, on one side, I don't see clear-cut benign features, but also now, now I'm more suspicious because I don't see benign features. I start seeing these little gray structures in the center, okay? And therefore, you see that by doing the inverse approach, I put my attention to a lesion which was, at the beginning, just nothing, you know? Morphologically not touching my brain in some way, okay? And this was a melanoma in situ, okay? Another example, this is a young lady, well, young, 42, 43, okay? So still already in the age of a possible lentigo maligna, because I told you, forget the age, okay? So this is a solitary lesion. Solitary means I have to look at it, you know? If there are many, I'm less suspicious, but if there is a solitary lesion, I have to check. And then I put my dermatoscope on the lesion, and then again I ask myself, do I see clear-cut benign features? A little bit of parallel lines, but is this prevalent? Not really. It's just a little bit. The periphery is not sharply demarcated. I'm not convinced. And now that I'm a little bit more suspicious, I start seeing the very tiny melanoma criteria, like this gray circle, gray area, structureless area here, gray circle again here. And now I put two things together. One side, no clear-cut benign features. On the other side, very tiny, subtle melanoma criteria. Now I know what to do. Certainly, I don't cryo this lesion. I take a picture and I ask the patient coming back in a few months, or I just remove it by a punch or by a shaving, whatever. And this was, again, a melanoma in situ. Okay, so this is the method we usually apply on the face. And since I use this method, I feel, let me tell you, much more relaxed with these lesions on the face, because before, you don't know how many small, subtle melanomas, early melanomas I missed on the face of my patients. Many, really many. Okay, with this method, of course, this method is not a miracle, is allowing 90% sensitivity and about 70% specificity. So it's not perfect, but it's a way of managing this type of difficult melanoma.